A fox on the front. I thought we could look at the animals and give them a little bit of a brush. I have some brushes here. This one's a paintbrush. I can brush the whiskers. I have another very soft paintbrush. That's a bit of fur in it, so it's already been around. Some wooden makeup brushes. Like it's got a little bit of powder still in it. Just a little bit. And the last brush I have is a suede brush. It has what looks like nylon bristles on the outside, and copper bristles on the inside. Can you hear them? They have a metallic sound. This brush is for suede. And before we start, we should have some tea. Lovely Moroccan mint from Waitrose. A crisp, refreshing blend of Chinese green gunpowder tea with aromatic mint leaves. So named because its leaves make little globs. Doesn't remind me much of gunpowder, but that's what it's called. They're like little tiny balls of a leaf balled up. It's a silk. A mole, The animals against a frosty, snowy landscape, but also help them to conserve heat. In winter, foxes become very active as they search for mates. They bark and scream to draw attention to themselves. Although these animals are nocturnal, they can be seen once the sun begins setting, which occurs in the afternoon. This time of year. Shall we brush him? Our little stoat. Shall we brush the teacup? November, salmon embark on their incredible journeys upstream where they will spawn or lay eggs. These journeys take place soon after the first heavy rains in Clear River. Mammals are social animals and often appear near the coast in a group or school. Sometimes it's possible to spy them surfing in the waves, jumping several meters out of the water, or even tossing seaweed around in what appears to be a game. Bottlenose dolphins are also known as grey porpoises, black porpoises, and cowfish. And there's our scale, that's a domestic cat, and that's the dolphin there. Dolphins and porpoises are cetaceans, which means they have filter use a nice soft one on him. It's a very nice soft one, isn't it? Very fast runner. Foxes and young hares may be caught by birds of prey, often found in open grassland, and wander into nearby gardens. Oh, there's a bat, a brown, long-eared. Faces can be pretty cute if it weren't for the rest of them. It seems that the other bits and pieces of their body look rather mismatched somehow. These little mammals can detect a single insect on the ground just by the noise it makes as it walks. Brown, long-eared bats are also known as whispering bats, because they produce sounds that are extremely quiet. My, my, the common rat, Mr. Rat, almost as big as Mr. Cat. Miss Cat. Brown rats are rarely seen because they're most active at night. What is this fellow doing? He's stealing eggs from another animal. Could be a duck. Could be a heron. Could be a lizard or a snake. Rodents live almost everywhere that humans live. They're found in towns, cities, and the countryside. Anywhere they can find food. Often associated with sewers. But rats also live in hedgerows and fields. Highly intelligent creatures with natural curiosity. Sounds like humans. They can live in large groups or colonies and fight one another for the best territory. Common seal. Nearly half of the European population of common seals live around the coast of Britain. Now, I've seen these fellows quite often, popping their heads up curiously or drying themselves off on rocks. The common seal is also known as the harbor seal. There's one drying himself off on the beach. The common shrew. He's actually bigger than I thought a shrew was. The last shrew I saw in the wild was so tiny it could fit right there in my hand. It might have been a baby. It's the only one I've ever seen in the wild. Here's one eating an earthworm. shrew has to eat 80 to 90% of its own body weight in food every 24 hours, or it will starve to death. That's a lot of calorie burning. Experts at remaining hidden beneath vegetation, and they have to spend most of their lives looking for food and eating. With a good sense of smell, they can detect prey up to 12 centimeters underground. A vole can easily be mistaken for a rat. However, if they stay still long enough to be identified, their plump bodies and the thicker fur are obvious. Like they have furrier ears as well. And a short, furry tail. Not a mouse or a rat. Another bat. Some baby bats. The dormouse with its fluffy tail. Look at his little schoolyard ones. They had to call in specialists to come and capture him and take him back to the forest because I think he was lost. Most fallow deer live in parks where they are protected. Now, an English or British park is different from an Australian or American park. Residents and nobility could have them to hunt for food. So they kept herds of them, very similar to a ranch. These fallow deer are particularly active at dawn and dusk. Spend much of their time grazing. Feral cats were once unwanted pets. They're not a different type of pet to cats. They just have a different lifestyle. Some more tea. In grassland, scrub, woodland, and hedge grows. And here he's eating a blackberry. That one. The hedgehog. I think he needs the copper brush. Unusual to see moles. They spend most of their lives underground, digging and sleeping. The mountain hare. He's cleaning his face. Shall we help? Is native to Britain, found only in Scotland and northern regions of England. Look, he's almost bigger than the cat and has huge, long shy and likely to disappear beneath the water's surface when they're disturbed. They mostly eat fish. Otters find it hard to survive in polluted water. Well, who doesn't? And this has affected their numbers in recent years. so happy when you see them playing in the water. Oh, isn't he just darling? A pine marten. Pine martens are nocturnal. They make their dens in tree holes, old squirrel nests, and rocky crevices. Outside Scotland. Look at his little fluffy tail. More bats. A polecat. Polecats are easy to identify. Struggling to find food, but they're normally active at dusk or night. Carnivores, they hunt rabbits, rodents, frogs, toads, and birds found in England and Wales. Is it cute little shrew. Let's give him a very soft brush. Look at his feet and his long nose. The UK's smallest mammal. In the 11th century to provide fur and meat. Does that look like Peter or Flopsy, Mopsy or Cottontail or Benjamin? One with some antlers. Rubbing the velvet off. The red fox. Now widespread in the countryside, towns and cities. They scavenge from rubbish bins. Almost any food lying around. Females are called vixens, and they're smaller than the male, which are called dogs. Red squirrel, smaller than their grey cousins. Much harder to spot nowadays. places in Britain, they've been able to survive. They usually live in woodlands with conifer trees, where they chew on pine cones and nibble the pine seeds. Brown fur on their back. Cute little face, little ears, closely related to weasels, pine martens, otters, minks, and weasel. There he is in his winter coat. His head's slightly different from the stoat, and his tail doesn't have a black tip. And you can see he's slightly bigger than the stoat. Survive for more than 24 hours without food. The wood mouse coastal habitats. Chip chap. And relaxed. You deserve a nice restorative sleep. Be good to yourself.